And with that, we hit you right at 5 o'clock on this now historic Friday. Thanks for joining us. You've been watching the special report from CBS News following the breaking news from Washington. Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg has died at the age of 87, serving 27 years on the nation's highest court, becoming one of its most prominent members.
CBS 13's Adrian Moore is in the newsroom with more on what this means for the court and also the country. Adrian.
Yeah, sad day, guys. Ginsburg was a champion, of course, of gender equality and considered an architect of the women's rights movement in the 70s. President Bill Clinton, of course, tapped her for the Supreme Court back in 1993. In a statement, the court said she died at her home in Washington, D.C., surrounded by her family. Justice Ginsburg is the second woman ever picked for the nation's highest court. According to NPR, Ginsburg dictated a statement to her granddaughter just a few days ago, saying, quote, "My most fervent wish is that I will not be replaced until a new president is installed." Her death will no doubt have profound consequences for the court and the country. She was considered the leader of its liberal wing, but with the court about to open a new term, Chief Justice John Roberts no longer holds the controlling vote in closely contested cases. Ginsburg had been undergoing chemotherapy and recently said she had no plans to retire from the Supreme Court. It was just last Wednesday when she was honored in a virtual ceremony with the Liberty Award in Philadelphia. Again, very sad news this evening for you. Supreme Court Justice and feminist icon Ruth Bader Ginsburg has died at the age of 87.
Yeah, we need to point out that she was just a true fighter. No matter your beliefs and your side of the aisle, I mean, cancer is a beast, as we all know. I do know that she had it running in her family. She lost her mother to cancer, of course, her husband as well. But we always heard about RBG just going out and keep on working out and trying to beat cancer and survive.
No doubt about it.